soul, are you wearied and troubled? No light in the darkness you see. There's life for a look at the Savior, and life more abundant and free. Oh, turn your eyes upon Jesus. Look full in his wonderful face, and the things of earth will grow strangely dim in the light of his glory. Death into life everlasting, he passed and we follow him there. O'er us and no more has dominion, for more than conquerors we are. Turn your eyes upon Jesus. Look full in his wonderful face, and the things of earth will grow strangely dim in the light of his glory and grace. His word shall not fail you, he promised. Believe him and all will be well. Then go to a world that is dying, his perfect salvation to tell. And turn your eyes upon Jesus. Look full in his wonderful face, and the things of earth will grow strangely dim in the light of his glory and grace. In the light of his glory.
Hello, Pennsylvania. My name is David Ashcraft. That was Matt Goss singing. We're part of LCBC Church, which is located in Mannheim, Pennsylvania, a church with 15 locations across central Pennsylvania. Maybe you, like me, grew up singing that song, and it was a song that served as a constant reminder to me that whenever things didn't go the way I'd planned, the way I'd hoped, the way I'd expected, that if I would actually turn and fully focus on Jesus instead of what was going on around me, then I would find a sense of peace in my life. Now, what I didn't know about that song is it was actually written in 1918. During the Spanish flu of 1918, that was ravaging the world and the United States. It was written at a time where people were feeling troubled and worried and anxious over what was going on around them. And it served to them as a reminder that rather than focus on the pandemic that they were experiencing, instead to focus fully on Jesus. Now, what happens when we turn our eyes on Jesus? What happens when we look full in his wonderful face? The song tells us, then the things of this world grow strangely dim in light of his wonderful face. Now, the writer of Hebrews actually says a very similar thing in Hebrews chapter 12, verse 2. The writer says, and let us run with endurance the race that God has set before us. We do this by keeping our eyes on Jesus, the champion who initiates and perfects our faith. Let us keep our eyes on Jesus, the one who overcomes the world. The challenge is for you and me, rather than focus on what's going wrong in our lives, instead to focus fully on Jesus, the one who has overcome the world. So my prayer for you today is that as we experience this pandemic, this virus that's happening all around us, rather than being overcome by fear, anxiety, or the stresses of what's happening around us, instead, as we focus on Jesus, we experience his strength, his peace, his goodness. Pennsylvania, let me pray for us. Heavenly Father, I ask, God, that you would encourage us today, that you would encourage us, first of all, to look full into Jesus' wonderful face. And as we do, as we focus on Jesus, Father, may the anxiety, may the frustrations, may the worries and the stress of today and all the things that are going on around us, may they truly grow strangely dim. May they pale in comparison to the love and the peace and the strength that Jesus provides. Heavenly Father, I ask that you would give us protection. I ask that you would give us good health, that you would watch over and protect your children here in Pennsylvania. And we pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. Pennsylvania, may God bless you today. May he encourage you and strengthen you as you look full into the wonderful face of Jesus.